Hello everybody, I am E. Krishnarao Patro. Today we will discuss about one important problem, that is merge sort, one of the sorting technique. So in the previous session you have seen the various types of other sorting. Now today one more important sorting, that is merge sort. This is a special type of sorting which uses divide and conquer policy, and this is one of the best sorting algorithm whenever you are having a huge collection of data in an external storage device also. So merge sort is a divide and conquer algorithm. It divides the input array into two halves. So whatever the input you are giving, it will divide into two halves, and each half will be sorted separately, and finally both has to be merged together, because the name itself, merging. The merge function is used for merging two halves. The merge function is useful for merging two halves, because whenever we are giving the one entire array, that array will be divided into two halves. Again, the two array will be again divided into again two more. It will be keep on dividing until it get a single element. This is the process. So this merge function is used to merge two halves. It takes actually four parameters: the original array, the left index, middle index, as well as the right index. So that means you should get left, middle and right index, which is a key process to assume that array left to middle and middle plus one to array. That means this is first half, this is the second half. So this will be keep on dividing into two halves. And the algorithm behind this sorting is, first it will check whether right index is greater than left or not. If this condition true, then it will find the middle position, middle point. How it will find the middle position? By adding left to plus right divided by 2. So when you divide left plus right by 2, automatically you will get the middle point. So the middle point will give you the exact position of the half. So you have to call this merge function two times. So that means here you are applying recursive approach. The array left position as well as middle position. Again you are calling same merge sort two times, array middle plus one to R, because you have gone up to middle in the first half. Now middle plus one to right most index. So these two merge sort will be calling recursively until you get an individual element. Once you reach individual elements, then whichever come from the same parent, they will be merging together in a sorted order. So this merge function will be doing merging one in a sorted order. And the time complexity for this process is order of n log n in all the cases. Best case, average case, as well as worst case. So this is one of the stable sort. One of the stable sort. That means it will be maintaining the order of the element before sorting as well as after sorting for the same value data. When the data is same, the order in which they came, same way it will come. If at all same data is repeating multiple times. So in the input order in which form they are there, in the right means output also, those order will be followed. This order will not be changing at all. That is the nature of the stable sort. So merge sort is one type of stable sort. Now you can see one simple diagram how this process works. Later on we will go for the program. Initially you assume that there are set of data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are 7 data set, and all the data in haphazard order. That means they are not in a sorted order. So the process says what? The whole data will be divided into first two half. So first half, how will you go to half? That means you should, this is the first position, second position, third position, fourth position, fifth position, sixth position and seventh position. So when there are 7 data, automatically there will be uneven. That means equal number you will not get. In one part you will get 4, in another part you will get 3. So 1 to 4 comes in first half and 5 to 7 comes in second half. Again these 4 will be divided into 2 parts. First half 2, second half also 2. Similarly here also there are 3 elements. So when there are odd number of elements, one half will be always one more than other. So here 9 and 32 comes in first part and 10 comes in second part. Now this 38 and 27, now this process will continue until you get the single element. So this will be divided into two part. Similarly, here also if you observe there are two elements, it will also divide into two part. Similarly, 9 and 32, it is also having even number of elements. Now it will also divide into two part. So you are getting now two elements. 10 is a single element, stop here. So that means you have reached two individual elements. Once you reach the individual elements, then you have to merge it. So how will you merge? The element which belongs to the same parent, first it will merge. Now see, 38 and 27, they belong to the same parent. So it will merge 27 and 30 because it is going in order, in a ascending order. Similarly, 43 and 3, they are came from same parent. So it will merge into this. So 9 and 32 belongs to same parent. It will merge into single one. 10 single elements. Now, these two, this group as well as this group, both belong to same grandparent. So these two will be changed. And while merging, it will merge as per order, means ascending order. First 3 comes, then 27 comes, then 38 comes, then 43 comes. Now observe here, while merging, it will be merging as per the order. Similarly, these 3 elements will merge in a order. Now, this group and this group both belong to same grandparent. Now, first you will get 3, then you will get 9, then you will get 9. After getting 9, then 10, then you are getting 27, then 38, then 43, then 82. So that means all elements are arranged here. So when you reach here, merging, it will be done. Up to this, it is dividing. Up to middle, it is divided into two equal halves. Once it has reached two individual elements in the group, then it will start merging. So at final level, you will be getting in a sorted order. So finally, you will get the sorted data. This is the process works. Now you can see one video how it is merging. Now please observe here. Every time, see, until it gets a single element started. Now it is merging. Now this 1 and 3 belong to same parent. Now 7 and 8 belong to same parent. So now it is arranging in order. Similarly, 2 and 4 belong to same parent. It is putting in the same order. Now 5, 6 and 1 and 3 both belong to same parent. So 1 comes first, then 3, then 5, then 6. Then 7, 8 and 2, 4 in the right side. Now it will be merging. Now the merging process started. 2, 4, 7, 8. Now this is one group, this is another group. These two groups now merging into single one. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Now 5 come from first half. Then 6. Then 7. Then 8. Okay. So this is the way the merging process. So initial process is what? Division. Because this algorithm follows divide and conquer policy. So its duty is first divide into single group. The group should contain only single elements. Once the group contains single elements, it will start merging into the whole group in a ascending order. So this is the way it works. So this is the video way of representing. So from the video, you can understand easily how the merge sort works. Now observe here how this process is going on. Now it is merging into two broad group. Now these two broad group will be combined into single group, final one. And while merging, it will check the smallest element first. So because it is going for ascending order. If at all you want to descending order, then you have to find biggest element. So here it is going for ascending order. That's why it's checking smallest element. So this way it works. Now we'll see how the merge sort program you can write. So you can write the merge sort program using Python. See, now this is the diagrammatic way of representing whole data divided into two halves. Again, this is divided into two halves. Again, divided into two halves. Then this is divided into two single elements, single elements, single elements, single element. This division process will continue until you get the single elements. Once you reach the single elements, it will combine it. It will combine it. And while combining by merging, it will merge in a ascending order. So 20 come first, 100 next, 15, 30, 5, 75, and 40. And these will be merging. While merging, it will be one group, this is another group. And these two will be merged and you will be getting the ascending order of the fuel data. Now see how you can write the program using Python. Right? So initially my array takes the parameter like first array, then left index, then right index. I am passing three parameters. That means I will be knowing what is the array, where the element exists, as well as the starting index as well as ending index. That means left index as well as right index. Here I am taking condition. If left index is less than right index, if this condition true, then here my goal is to find the middle position. Once you get the middle position, you can split into two parts. That's why how to find the middle position? Left plus right, double division 2, because this is your integer division. So if you write single slash, what will happen? This will go for float division, but float division will not give you the middle part. So you have to get the integer part. That's why double slash, because you are following Python. If you are writing in C, then single slash, but you are writing in Python, put a double slash. So after getting the middle part, then you have to call again this method two times. Method with array left index up to middle. This is first hub. And second time when you are calling array middle plus 1 with right index, that is the second hub. That means you are calling method two times in a recursive way. They are all recursive approach. And finally, you would call the merge. So while calling merge, you would pass these four parameters: array, left index, right index, as well as the middle index. Because the middle index will tell the where exactly the first half ends, as well as where exactly second half begins. Because middle is nothing but end of the first half. And middle plus one is start half, second half. That's why you have to pass these four parameters. Once this program is ready, then this merge function you would write. This is the main one you have to write. So here you have to write what? Left from left index to up to middle plus one, that gives you first half. And middle plus one to till right index plus one, that gives you second half. That means you got two copy, left copy as well as right copy. Because after getting the middle, you are getting two. And you have to start merging. So while merging, what you have to do? Start from first half as well as from second half. Take each element, left half first element and right half first element. If any element is smaller, whichever element is small, that part you copy into final array. So this process will continue. Otherwise, if right half is greater, then copy the right half into the array. So this process will continue until one of the portion is complete, or one of the half is complete. So this loop will continue till one half is over. When this loop is over, either the first half is over or second half is over, because you are copying into the final array. If first half is some elements are there, then remaining element again you have to copy one by one until you reach the length of the left copy. Sometime this may be over, but still this may be there. If this copy is there, that means right half is still exist. It is not copied completely. Then while j less than length of right copy, copy this one by one until you reach all the elements. So this process is continuing. And this is your driver program. That means the main program from where the control starts. This is the driver code. Initially array is given, and the array is not in a sorted order. This is in ascending order. And this method I am calling array with starting index, that is the left index, and length of array minus 1, that gives the right index. So after getting left index and right index, then you can call method. There you can the process starts. Once this process is over, then it will print the sorted array. So this is your printed data, means sorted data. So now we will go to our idle environment, how you can execute it. Let us go to idle. Yeah, before that, try to know the time complexity also. the best case time complexity is order of n log n, worst case is order of n log n, and average case also order of n log n. That means in all the three cases, the time complexity is same. And remember, as it is a divide and conquer policy, so whenever divide and conquer policy applies, this is logarithmic series. And this is dividing the program into n time. So n time it has to match. So that's why order of n log n. So the time complexity for this is order of n log n. Now we'll go to idle. Now I'll go to a new file. We will start the program. First we'll write the comment. Our goal is do merge sort. Here the first duty is you have to read the data. After reading data, then we will call the merge sort function. There you have to find the middle position of the complete set. Then I will come to the middle. After coming to middle, then I will divide the list in two parts. From beginning to till middle, that is first half. Middle plus one to till end, that is second half. So this process I will continue until you get the single elements. So how will I know single? Until left is less than r, this process will continue. Whenever left is equal to r or greater r, that means it has reached to single elements. So this recursive process I have to stop it. Once the recursive division process is over, then I have to go for merging. So that means I have to write the three statements. Two merging means two merge sort function and one merging function. So let us write a merge sort. This is my function. So in Python, when you want to write a function, then you have to write a keyword called def. Def merge sort. And this merge sort, it will take the three parameters. What are the parameter? First parameter is the original array. The second one is the left index. Left index. And the next one is the right index. So I got left index as well as right index. After that, here I have to check whether the left index is still less than right index or not. Why I have to check? Because I told you it has to go until the group contains single elements. So if left index is less than right index, if this condition satisfies, then it says that still there are some more elements exist. Here now, once this condition true, that means still there are some elements are there, more than one elements are there. So now I have to come to middle. So how to go to middle? So middle equal to left index plus right index divided by 2. So I am putting integer division. If you write single class, then go to float. But float will not work here. That's why I write double class. Now, here what I will do, I will call my merge sort. Merge sort. I will pass my array as well as I will pass my left index as well as I will go up to middle. Then I will go to second half. So how to go to second half? So in the merge sort, I will pass my array, comma, middle plus 1, because already middle part is over there. So I will go to middle, middle plus 1 until I go to right index, right index. So this is now dividing into two parts. Now you will go for merging. Merge. Because see, in merge there are two things. One is division, second one is merging. So after this division is over, now merging. So in the merge part, you can call this array, okay, followed by the left index, followed by the right index, followed by middle. So that means these three parameters are essential for this. Okay. So, if left index is less than right index, this process will continue. Whenever left index is equal to right index, this terminus, that means the method work is over. So, else part you may write, may not write. Not required. Now, we'll write the match function. Match. Here, I'll pass these four parameters. First one is the array. Second one is the left index. And the next one is the right index. And the next one, last one is the middle. That means the required data for merging is over. So, once you know the left index as well as right index, then you can divide the list into two halves. So, you know leftmost index, you know rightmost index. And where exactly the left is ending, means the first half is ending, that is nothing but the middle. So, here what I will do, I will divide into two parts. So, I will make two copy, left copy and right copy. So, my left copy equal to array of, because this is my list, array of left index from left index to till middle index plus middle index plus 1, because including middle I have to continue. Okay. So I got the left copy, similar right copy. Right copy equal to array of, so I have to start from, already I have gone to middle plus 1. So because here now middle plus 1 is not included, when you say splitting, it will means when it is doing the slicing, it will go up to this middle. So from, I will start from again middle plus 1, from middle plus 1 to right index plus 1. Okay. So, you are dividing the list into two half, left copy and right copy, left half and right half. So, now after this, I have to start merging. So, I will make one index, initial I 0, j also 0, and my k start from, because I have to start merging, while merging, I have to start from the left index. So, k equal to left index, I will write. Left index. So I got my left index. Now here what I will do? Start merging. Start merging. From left copy and right copy, I will take both and put in my original array. My original array is array. So I will put a loop while I less than length of left copy. Length of left copy and j less than, because while merging, sometime first copy may be small or sometime second copy may be small. So, whichever is terminating, that time you have to stop it. Means either first condition may fail or second condition may fail. So, here I will write until j less than length of right copy. So, we are putting either this condition or that condition. Whenever first condition is true, it says that, means if any of the condition fail, that loop will terminate. If I is less than left index, then true means go inside. As well as j is also less than this, then go. Both condition true means go inside. If one of the condition fail, then loop will terminate. So, here what I will do, I will put a condition. If left copy of I, now you have to do matching as well as in a sorted order. If array of, means left copy of I, because I is my index, left copy of I, if less than, and the right copy is pointed by j, because I have made two indicators, I and j, I for left copy, j for right copy. If this left copy of I is less than right copy of j, if this condition true, it says what? Left copy data is smaller. Whenever left copy data is smaller, then I have to put in the final array. That is my array. Array of where I have to store? Already I made one indicator called k. So here I will store array of k equal to left copy of I. Left copy of I. After copy, left underscore. Okay. Now left copy is copied. Now I should be incremented. I equal to I plus 1. So the next time I will go to next element of the left copy. Of course, the k also I should have to increase. But in the else part also I will be using else. Here what I will do? If this condition is not satisfying, that means left copy is not less. Left copy is more. That means right copy is smaller. If right copy is smaller, what I will do? Array of k, array of k equal to right copy of j, right copy of j. So this is copied. After that, my j has to increment. So j equal to j plus 1. So in both the case, the element is copied to original array. Then after storing in the original array, my k should increment. So k equal to k plus 1. Of course, you can write k equal to k plus 1 in both the case, if part as well as else part. Instead of writing two times, I write only once. Because it is common for both if as well as else condition. I wrote in single place. Now, this process will continue until both halves are copied to the original array. If one of the condition fail, then it will terminate. If at all anything is failed, then it will come out. There you have to check which part is failed, whether left part is failed or right part is failed. So here, how will you know? So I'll put a loop again. If left path is still, some elements are there still pending to copy, then I'll put a condition for left copy. Or sometime, right copy may be balanced. Complete right path is not copied. So I have to write one more while part. So I'll write here, while I less than, that means I is pointing to left path, less than length of left copy. That means all the elements are not copied if this condition is true. Now here what I will do, I will take the data from left copy and store in the my original array. So array of k equal to left copy of I, left copy of I. So that means ith element of the left copy is copied to this. After that what I will do, I have to go to second next element of the left copy. So I equal to I plus 1. At the same time, my k has to increment. K equal to k plus 1. Because here we are dealing with only single half. If this part is balanced, that means some portion of left copy, if it not copied, then this will execute. Sometime it may be copied completely, but still second part is there. So in that case, what I will do? I will put one more loop while. Why I am writing one loop? Because there may be more than one element pending. That's why loop I am writing. If there is a single element always pending, then write single if. But here there may be chance of multiple elements. While j less than length of right copy, j less than length of right copy. If this condition true, I will copy array of k equal to right copy of j. So jth element is copied now. And after that, j has to increment j equal to j plus 1 and k has to increment k equal to k plus 1. Now both half, left half as well as right half, both are copy. It says that the complete left copy, left part as well as right part are merged together. After merging, then I have to come and I should call my main function, my master. So I should write my master code. So in the master code, what I'll do? Here I will check. I'll take an array. Initially, my array, of course you can read the data also, but here I make it static something, some data, 10, 33, 22, 44, 13, 66, 55, 78, 16, assume this is a given set of data. So this given set of data you are matching now. So now here I have to call my main function, means this is my main function, I have to call my merge sort. So merge sort. So merge sort takes how many arguments? Merge sort takes array, left index as well as right index. So here I will call merge sort followed by the name of the array. Array left index is always 0 because starting index of any array is 0 first, followed by the right index. How will you know rightmost index? That is nothing but length of array. Length of array. But if I write length of array, length of array gives what? Now if you observe here, 1, here how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Totally 9 elements are there. But the index 0 to 8. 0 to 8. That's why what I have to do, instead of writing 9, I will write here minus 1. So, here I write minus 1. So, that I will get the rightmost index. So, when I call merge sort with the array as a parameter, means the array means what? List here. Here it is doing there itself. So, entire elements are stored there itself. Now, I will print the array. So, here I will print a message, the sorted data. Print array. So, I will be getting this. Slash n. Control S. Merge sort. So my program is now ready. Now let us run. So for that, I will go to run, the module F5. Still it is showing some error. Python line number 33. Line number 33 is showing error. Go to line number 33. So here I am calling merge sort with array A 0, comma length of array this minus 1. So this is my length of the array followed by minus 1. Print method I am calling here. Swelling merge sort array left index as well as right index. Merge sort. Control S F5. Line number 33. So I'll put a line number first. This format. Edit. Show line number. Let us check how to put the line numbers here. Formatted paragraph. Options. Configure idle. Options. Show line number here. So I got the line number. Here. Merge sort. It is saying that there is the error here. See now this what error? F5. Write copy equal to array middle plus 1 slash is tuple. Line number 33. What is this error? because we are calling the mesh sort, this parameter, array. The name of the array is array. The starting index is 0 and length of array minus 1. Passing array left index as well as right index. Left index less than means this we are calling and this one. And we are left copy equal to array left index colon middle plus 1. And here right copy equal to also middle plus 1. Here there is a mistake. Yeah. So while doing slicing, you would give a colon symbol. Control S F5. Yeah. So you must be very careful while writing the symbol. So now you got what? You see the sorted data 10, 13, 16, 22, 33, 44, 55, and 66, 78. So, this is the way you are getting. If at all you are interested to print before sorting, how are the data? So, before printing, you can call this also. You can print a message before printing or before sorting. Before sorting, how the data look like, total S, F5, yeah. So, before sorting, 10, 33, 22, 44, 13, 66, 65, 16, it was in a unorganized order, that means it was not sorted. So, finally, you got this. So, this is the way it is, fine. And this is your one of the divide and conquer sorting algorithm, and this is the one of the best algorithm for the external sorting, because you may have a huge volume of data. Whenever huge volume of data, mesh sort is the best one, and this is one of the stable sort. Remember, mesh sort is one type of stable sort. Now, it is a stable sort, as well as it is follows divide and conquer policy. Divide and conquer policy. Because most of the time they will ask which policy is followed by mesh sort. Then you should say divide and conquer policy. And is it a stable sort or not? Yes, it is a stable sort. Stable sort means what? Whenever the incoming order and outcoming order of the same value data, same, then that is stable sort. For example, I am having 18 and 18. Two input data are there. Now, 18, first 18, second 18. So, in output also, this first 18 should come first, second 18 should come first, second next. So, if both follow same order, then that is stable sort. For example, if this 18 come first and this 18 come next, then that is not a stable sort. So, you must be very careful for this. And they will ask, what are the time complexity for this algorithm? Time complexity is order of n log n base 2. In all the cases, best case, average case, as well as worst case, all the cases requires same time. But there is a special disadvantage here. It takes extra memory. It consumes extra memory. So, space complexity is more. Why? Because while dividing the list into two halves, it is making first half as well as second half in separate memory. That's why it consumes extra memory. So, sometime in exam, they may ask a question, what is the disadvantage in the mesh sort? Then you should say, the disadvantage of mesh sort is, it consumes extra memory. Space complexity is more here. Okay. So, this is the way you have to write the program. Yeah. Thank you.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.